Good morning. Let's do a problem where we determine centripetal acceleration. Bobby, please read the problem, and Bo, please translate.
Flippin' physics.
A cylindrical space station with a radius of 115 meters is rotating at 0.292 radians per second.
Stop. Radius equals 115 meters, and angular velocity equals 0.292 radians per second. Bobby, please.
A ladder goes from the rim to the center. What is the magnitude of the centripetal acceleration at 1, the top of the ladder, 2, the middle of the ladder, and 3, the base of the ladder?
Okay, so centripetal acceleration equals question mark for each of those locations. The radius I gave before of 115 meters is for part 3. The radius for part 2 is halfway up the ladder, or 115 divided by 2, which is 57.5 meters. And the radius for part 1 is 0.
Billy, please solve all three parts.
Okay, centripetal acceleration equals tangential velocity squared divided by radius, and centripetal acceleration also equals radius times angular velocity squared. Because the space station's velocity was given in radians per second, we know 0.292 radians per second is an angular velocity. Therefore, we should use radius times angular velocity squared for the centripetal acceleration. For part one, that means the centripetal acceleration equals zero times, well, it doesn't matter what the angular velocity is, the centripetal acceleration then at the top of the ladder equals zero. The centripetal acceleration for part two equals 57.5 times 0.292 squared, which is 4.90268 meter radian squared over second squared, and radians have no units, so it is just 4.90 meters per second squared with three significant digits. The centripetal acceleration for part three equals 115 times 0.292 squared, which is 9.80536, or 9.81 meters per second squared with three significant digits.
9.81 meters per second squared. Nice one, Mr. P.
The acceleration due to gravity here on planet Earth.
Nice.
Yes. When I stand on the interior rim of this rotating space station, I experience a centripetal acceleration equal to the acceleration due to gravity here on planet Earth. This is called artificial gravity. I actually feel as if I weigh exactly what I normally do on Earth. This concept has been shown in all sorts of movies. For example, 2001, A Space Odyssey, which was released in 1968, has a rotating space station for artificial gravity and shows Dr. Dave Bowman exercising while jogging on the space station's interior rim. Another movie, Elysium, features a giant rotating space station with permanent residents living on its interior rim. Using a rotating cylindrical space station, we can create artificial gravity. Pretty cool, eh?
Yeah, that is pretty cool. Yeah,
absolutely.
But realize, the jogging scene does not take place on Space Station 5. It takes place inside the Discovery 1 ship, which is on the way to Jupiter. And it's not Dr. Bowman, but his crewmate, Dr. Frank Poole, who is jogging in the scene. Also, it's said in the movie that Space Station 5 generates artificial gravity equal to the moon's gravity to allow travelers to acclimatize to the low gravity.
Wow. Thanks, Billy. Sorry about the misinformation.
Okay.
Okay, back to our cylindrical space station. What will I feel when I start climbing up the ladder?
Well, the radius decreases as you go up the ladder.
So the centripetal acceleration, or the artificial gravity, also decreases.
As you climb the ladder, you feel like you weigh less?
Yes. As I climb the ladder, the centripetal acceleration, which is causing the artificial gravity, decreases. which means I feel as if my weight is decreasing. But then, what happens at the top of the ladder when I let go of the ladder?
You just float there.
Exactly. Because there, the centripetal acceleration is zero, I will feel weightless and will, relative to the rest of the space station, just float there right next to the ladder. But I should tether myself to the ladder because if I accidentally give myself the slightest push, I will slowly float away from the ladder until I reach the outside of the space station. And I will have almost zero tangential velocity, but the tangential velocity of the rim of the space station is roughly 120 kilometers per hour or 75 miles per hour. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.